Westminster students are now receiving their A-level and vocational results despite not sitting any exams due to the pandemic.
Yesterday, ministers admitted that as many as 40% of results could be lower than those predicted by teachers. Last-minute changes have been made to the appeals process in order to avoid the controversy that unfolded in Scotland over downgrading results.
So, under the new rule, students in England and Northern Ireland can use mock exam results as a basis for any appeal. However, this doesn't guarantee they'll be awarded the same result as their mocks.
In Wales, pupils have been told that their AS results, which are usually achieved in the first year of the course, will be used if they're higher than the grades that are issued today.
Well, in the last half an hour, we've been speaking to the Education Secretary, Gavin Williamson, who said the vast majority of students will be awarded the grade their teachers predicted, or within one grade of it.
90% of all the results that are going to be awarded today are going to be either the grade of the school or within one grade of that school. And you're going to be seeing an increase in the number of children that get A or A stars by 2% this year over last year. And what you're going to be seeing is literally hundreds of thousands of students being in position to move on to the next stage of either going to university, going to college, or going into the world of work.
So let's talk to our political correspondent, Jonathan Blake, at Westminster. Morning to you, Jonathan. You think this through, don't you? You think about those schools shut, the exams cancelled, a much criticised system in its place, and today is the day when those A-level students are thinking, what next? What will my future be depending on what they open?
So much uncertainty for those students getting their grades this morning, Charlie, as you say, not on the basis of their exams and the work they put in, but on the basis of a prediction from their teachers, and then having that standardised by this process that the government and the exams watchdog in England and the comparative bodies elsewhere in the UK have put in place. And while there is huge uncertainty in the air about results for individual students and the results across the board and what they will look like, the Education Secretary, Gavin Williamson, for England has, as you've heard on the programme this morning, defended that system and said that he would not consider doing what happened in Scotland after there was so much criticism that so many students had their grades lowered, the system was scrapped and students ended up with the grade they were originally predicted by their teachers. He has admitted that some will get a grade that is not reflective of the work they put in and they will be able to take advantage of robust appeals process, as he put it, but there are big questions still this morning about how that appeals process will work, how long students and schools will have to take advantage of it, and how exactly mock exam results will be considered. So questions about that we're not expecting answers to until next week. So there is a huge amount riding on this process this morning, and depending on the spread of results and how they're received, I think depend on what the government does next. But a signal from the Education Secretary this morning that he is not prepared to do away with that standardisation system, which he says will mean that 90% of students get the grade they were predicted or receive one that's within one grade of that. And he said to do otherwise would be unfair to students and allow rampant